We're going to get started. The visitors will retire behind the rail. The members take their seat. We're going to get started. And if we could have a little quiet. Thank you. Thank you very much. Before we start, I just want to say if anyone has a cell phone or any other electronic device that makes noise, I'd ask that you please turn it on silent, or better yet, if you can turn it on. So we do not interrupt the proceedings. At this time, we'd like to give our invocation this morning. The chair recognizes the Rabbi Daniel Grodnitzky of Chabad Center for Students of Philadelphia. He's here today as a guest of Councilman Domb. I would ask all guests, visitors, and members to please rise. Rabbi.
Behold how good and pleasant it is when people sit in a spirit of togetherness. God Almighty, please bless this gathering of civil servants to feel a true sense of fellowship and common purpose. In the city of brotherly love, may this body serve as an example of the power of the few joining together to serve the many. Let the spirit of brotherhood of this council imbue all of the citizens of our city with a sense of responsibility one for another. As the Lubavitcher Rebbe, Rabbi Schneerson, once commented, the word Philadelphia in ancient Greek also means the city of wisdom. God Almighty, may you bless our city council members with the wisdom and foresight necessary to continue the growth and beautification of the facades of our buildings and the hearts and lives of all those who reside within them. The sages explain that the hearts of rulers are in the hands of heaven. God Almighty, please bless our council members to manifest your guiding hand in every righteous law that they pass and every just ordinance that they enact. Next week, we celebrate the New Year of trees in the Jewish calendar. Deuteronomy tells us that a man is like a tree of the field. Just as one seed planted and nurtured with love and care can grow into an entire tree, with many fruits, filled with many seeds, that will lead to generations of fruit-bearing trees. So too, one good deed planted in the soul of a friend or a stranger will ultimately lead to an incredible proliferation of goodliness and godliness in this world. The Talmud relates the story of an old man planting a fig tree on the side of a road in ancient Israel. When asked if he really expected to be able to live long enough to enjoy the fruits of his labor, he responded, "I was born into a world flourishing with ready-made pleasures. My ancestors planted for me, and now I plant for my children." May God Almighty bless this council to plant seeds that will positively affect generations upon generations of future Philadelphians. In conclusion, it is said that good leaders create followers. Great leaders create leaders. God Almighty, please bless the leaders of Philadelphia to serve as a source of leadership for others, to empower the masses to collectively make our city a shining example of goodness, fairness, and equal opportunity for all. Amen.
Amen. Rabbi, thank you so much for those inspiring words. Appreciate it. Council will be at ease. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. The next order of business is the approval of the journal and meeting of Thursday, January 26, 2017, and the chair recognizes Councilman Greenlee.
Thank you, Mr. President. I move that the journal of the meeting of Thursday, January 26, 2017 be approved.
Second.
Thank you. It has been moved and properly second that the journal of the meeting Thursday, January 26, 2017 stand approved. All those in favor say aye. Those opposed, the ayes have it, and the journal is approved. The next order of business is request for leave of absence, and the chair recognizes Councilman Heenan.
Thank you, Mr. President. On behalf of the majority, a leave of absence is requested for Council Members Jones and Johnson.
Chair thanks the gentleman. On behalf of the minority, the chair recognizes Councilman O'Neill.
Thank you, Mr. President. On behalf of the Republicans, there are no requests for leave of absence.
Thank you very much. At this point, I would like to dispense with the regular order of business, and I would like to welcome, and I want to thank everyone who have taken time out of their busy day to come down to witness their government in action. We hope that today is a knowledgeable one, and we actually hope that it's a pleasurable one, so much that you come back again. So again, thank you so much for coming down. At this time, Chair recognizes Councilwoman Blackwell, who presents a resolution honoring Dr. Arthur C. Evans. With Dr. Evans and those accompanying him, please join the Councilwoman at the podium. And joining the Councilwoman, we have Councilman Greenlee, Councilwoman Reynolds Brown, Councilman O, and I believe Councilwoman Bass, Councilwoman Gim, and Councilwoman Dom, and Councilwoman Parker. I'm sorry, Councilman Dom. I'm sorry. Sorry, Councilman. You do not look like a woman. And Councilman Taubenberger. And we have Councilman Squilla.
Yeah, they said he was there.
So now, Doctor, you have to come up too. Yeah we kind of need you. Yeah. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Mr. President. This is an extreme honor. When we heard that Dr. Evans was moving on, not only I said, oh no, but all my staff said, oh no. He's been so open and responsive to all of us. It doesn't matter who you are, what your title is. And so I start calling him not only for his department, but for health and for anything I could think of. And he's always been there. So we certainly will miss him. And I don't know how we'll do to survive. I guess I have to learn who's supposed to do what and do the right thing and refer to the right people. But we certainly appreciate him. We thank him. We see him at many affairs because he's just that kind of person. And it is with great pleasure and honor that we present him this resolution. Resolution honoring and recognizing Dr. Arthur C. Evans for his accomplishments and numerous contributions to the City of Philadelphia on the occasion of his retirement from the Department of Behavioral Health and Intellectual Disability Services and congratulating him on his appointment as CEO of the American Psychological Association.
Whereas Arthur C. Evans Jr., PhD, holds a doctorate in clinical community psychology from the University of Maryland and a master's degree in experimental psychology from Florida Atlantic University, where he also completed his undergraduate work. Whereas Dr. Evans is the Commissioner of Philadelphia's Department of Behavioral and Intellectual Disability Services, DBHIDS, a $1 billion healthcare agency that is the behavioral health and intellectual disability safety net for more than 1.5 million Philadelphians. And?
Whereas the department has undergone a system-wide transformation under the leadership of Dr. Evans. Improved outcomes for people accessing services has resulted in fewer inpatient admissions, visits to crisis centers, and significant cost savings that the city has reinvested in community-based services and supports. And
whereas prior to his work in Philadelphia, Dr. Evans was the Deputy Commissioner for the Connecticut Department of Mental Health and Addiction Services, where he led major strategic initiatives for the Connecticut behavioral health care system. He played a significant role in implementing a recovery-oriented policy framework, addressing health care disparities, and increasing the use of evidence-based practices, leading-edge research, and community engagement. And
whereas Dr. Evans holds faculty appointments at the University of Pennsylvania School of Medicine and the Philadelphia College of Osteopathic Medicine, and has held faculty appointments at the Yale University School of Medicine and Quinnipiac University. And
whereas Dr. Evans has been recognized nationally for his work in behavioral health care policy and the transformation of service delivery systems. In 2015, he was recognized by the White House as an advocate for action by the Office of National Drug Control Policy. And
whereas in 2013, Dr. Evans received the Dr. Nathan Davis Award for Outstanding Government Service, the American Medical Association's Top Government Service Award in Healthcare, for his leadership in transforming the Philadelphia behavioral health system, particularly around the adoption of a public health approach. And
whereas Dr. Evans has served in several national leadership roles, including chair of the Federal Substance Abuse and Mental Health Services Administration, Partners for Recovery Initiative Steering Committee, co-chair of the National Action Group on Fostering System Reforms for Adults with Serious Mental Illnesses, member of SAMHSA's Center for Substance Abuse Treatment Advisory Committee, chair of the National Advisory Committee for the Robert Wood Johnson Foundation's Pathway to Recovery Project, and president of the Board of Directors of the New England Institute of Addiction Studies, Board of Directors for the Melville Charitable Trust, the nation's largest philanthropic focus exclusively on ending homelessness. And
whereas, with a proven track record of innovative and effective solutions to complex system changes, Dr. Evans brings diverse training and experience as a scientific practitioner and policymaker. He is in high demand as a resource for his fellow psychologists, healthcare administrators, and community, service, and government leaders. And an adept and versatile public speaker, Dr. Evans speaks to behavioral health leaders and organizations across the country. And
whereas in January 2017, Dr. Evans was named Chief Executive Officer of the American Psychological Association, APA, Dr. Evans will assume his position there on March the 20th. As CEO of the APA, Dr. Evans will head the leading scientific and professional organization representing psychology in the United States, with more than 117,500 researchers, educators, clinicians, consultants, and students as its members.
Now, therefore, be it resolved that the Philadelphia City Council hereby honors and recognizes Dr. Arthur C. Evans for his accomplishments and numerous contributions to the City of Philadelphia on the occasion of his retirement from the Department of Behavioral Health and Intellectual Disability, and congratulates him on his appointment as CEO of the American Psychological Association. Further resolved that an engrossed copy of this resolution be presented to Dr. Evans as sincere expression of the Philadelphia City Council's gratitude and recognition. Thank you.
Thank you. And the chair recognizes Dr. Evans for remarks.
First of all, I am so honored, and I just can't tell you how much I appreciate all of you for standing here and recognizing me in this way. But I'm very clear that any success that we've had as a department depends on the people that I work with every day. And a few of them came today. We're about 700 strong, but I want all of them to stand up. Everyone from the Department of Behavioral Health and Intellectual Disability Services, could you all stand up? Could we give them a round of applause? These folks do a tremendous job for the citizens of Philadelphia, and I'm forever indebted to them. I remember my first testimony in city council, and back then I went last after all of the human services organizations and right before lunch. And so by the time you all would get to me, I would be sitting there just crossing out my testimony. So by the time I got to the end, there was literally one person left, and that was whoever was chairing. I was standing between that person and lunch. And so I would, you know, do one paragraph and ask if there were any questions. And then, you know, invariably the person would say, "Nah, we're good." And that was it. To today, where, you know, I think my record is 3.5 hour testimony. And that shows a remarkable change and understanding of the importance of behavioral health issues in the city. And so I'm so grateful to you all. It sharpens us when you ask us tough questions, when you probe us, when you question us. And I want to thank you all for, I know that sounds a little sadistic, but I do want to, or masochistic, I should say. But it does help us when we go back, because we take what you ask us about, the issues that your constituents bring to you, and we go back and we try to work on those problems. So I want to thank you for that. I have with me some of my family members. So I want my parent-in-laws to stand up. They're all the way from Grand Bahama, Freeport, Grand Bahama. They said, come on up for the picture. Come on up for the picture. I have one of my daughters who's representing my three daughters. Akila, come on up. We call her the knee baby. And I have my partner, a life partner for 30 years, 32 years, 31. I knew that. Word to the wise, never go to the numbers. But my wife, Claudine, who's also here with me as well. Finally, I just want to thank all of the people that have supported our agency. We don't do this work in isolation. We have providers, and I think there's some providers here and people in the community. And one of the things that I am most proud of in my tenure, there are a couple of things. One of them is that we have worked extremely hard to make sure that people who live in the margins get the best services that they possibly can. We go out and we get the best scientists in the world, and we partner with them to make sure that people who have Medicaid and people who are uninsured get the best services. And I can tell you that people in Philadelphia get services that are comparable to what you could get, and in many cases better, because we're working with the creators of some of those practices. But the other thing that I'm enormously proud of, and I have many staff here who've done this, is that we are reaching into the community and not just waiting for people to show up, but going into communities and connecting with people. And I think that that makes a huge difference, particularly for issues that are as stigmatized as mental health and addiction and intellectual disability. So I want to thank all the people that partner with us, our sister agencies, this council, and certainly the mayor. And I've worked for three mayors, and I've had the opportunity to serve under three administrations. And each one of them understands the importance of what we do and have supported us. So thank you all very much. I appreciate you. And you all can't get rid of me. I'm still going to be connected to Philadelphia. So thank you.
Council meetings.
Thank you very much. At this time, the chair recognizes Councilwoman Quiñones-Sánchez, who will present a resolution recognizing Battalion Chief Joaquin Enrique Colon Jr. Would Battalion Chief Colon and those accompanying him please join the Councilwoman at the podium? And joining the Councilwoman, we have Councilman Squilla, Councilman Taubenberger, and
good morning.
Morning.
Sorry, I'm trying to get these titles correct. Don't want to make sure I recognize everyone. I want to take a moment of personal privilege and speak to the high level of respect I have for our firefighters here in the city. Having experienced my own personal fire in my home, we always talk about the high level of professionalism within our first responders, but when you see it in action, you gain a new appreciation for these brave women and men who, as we're running from something, they're running to something. And it's not just the fire and the cleanup. It is how they treat you and your precious belongings and the empathy that they have throughout this, from the fire marshals to everyone else. And, you know, I've been in a position to see firsthand the valuable work that they have done. And I must say, as I will be strongly advocating for this department's budget, the last 8 years we have not been good to the fire department, and I want to make sure that the next eight, and I know the mayor shares my concern, that we give these professional folks the tools that they need so that we can have a first-class fire department. And so within that, we have ranks, and in the Puerto Rican Latino community, we are especially pleased today in recognizing what is a historic designation of our highest ranking Latino ever in the department, in the fire department. So I want to thank Deputy Chief James Redinger for joining us here today, and the other members here who will get introduced later. Chief Colon had the opportunity to be the chief in my particular fire also. So I was reassured because I knew the fire department was good, but I was even more reassured when I saw Chief Colon in charge of the scene. And he reassured me as they broke all my windows that everything was gonna be okay. But Chief Colon is not only a high professional in the fire department, he's been involved in the community, he cares about the community, and I look forward to his next chapter in his life, him taking his expertise and what he's done, and continuing to help us bring more diversity into the fire department, but also in helping us train further firefighters. I want to thank Noel Bermudez, who is the president of the Spanish American Professional Firefighters Association. Noel is my neighbor, but under his leadership and over the course of the last few years with Captain Crespo and others, they've bought a headquarters in my district, and so they're actively working with our fire commissioner and with Local 22 in recruiting and bringing more Hispanics into the fire department. And so this is personal for me because these are my very, very good friends, and I want to thank Councilman Taubenberger and Squilla for joining me this morning. So with that, recognizing and honoring Battalion Chief Joaquin Enrique Colon Jr., on the occasion of his retirement following 34 years of loyal and dedicated service to the City of Philadelphia. The Council of the City of Philadelphia is pleased and proud to recognize and honor Battalion Chief Joaquin Enrique Colon Jr., the first Latino Battalion Chief, on the occasion of his retirement following 34 years of loyal and dedicated service to the City of Philadelphia. Whereas Battalion Chief Colon is the proud father of five wonderful children and a grandfather to 12 grandchildren, who led a successful career while juggling his time as father, grandfather, and husband to his wife, who joins us this morning, Elizabeth Rodriguez Colon, mother and father battling Alzheimer's, and as a battalion chief of the Philadelphia Fire Department. And
whereas, after serving his country, the United States Air Force, Battalion Chief Colon began his illustrious career in the Philadelphia Fire Department in 1983. And was later promoted to lieutenant in 1999 and captain in 2006. He was again promoted to battalion chief in 2011, where he became the first Latino in PFD history to receive that ranking. And whereas his Battalion Chief Colon is well respected by his superiors and colleagues, and in his presence at the Philadelphia Fire Department will be sorely missed. His spirit and enthusiasm have been a paramount positive influence and is held in high esteem by all. Joaquin has received numerous honors throughout his career for his definitive impact on the city and its citizens, including the 2006 Outstanding Fireman of the Year from the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, citations from City Council and Pennsylvania 3rd Senatorial District, and being named Uniform Citizen of the Year by 6ABC News. And whereas Battalion Chief Colon Jr. has been an active member of the Spanish American Professional Firefighters Association, SAPFA, where he has helped and mentored a number of Puerto Rican and Latino fire department recruits, as well as assisting his fellow members in advance within the fire department. And
whereas on February 3rd, 2017, Battalion Chief Joaquin Enrique Colon, Jr. will be joined by the Spanish American Professional Firefighters Association, his loving friends, family, and fellow fighters to commemorate his historic career at the Philadelphia Fire Department. Whereas we in this council join in wishing Battalion Chief Colon well in any of his future endeavors and hope his retirement is filled with happiness, good health, and the joys of family and friends. And
therefore, by virtue of this citation, the Council of the City of Philadelphia hereby recognizes, honors the 34 years of loyal and outstanding service that the Battalion Chief Joaquin Enrique Colon has dedicated to the Philadelphia Fire Department. We commend Joaquin for his great work, and we extend our sincere respect and admiration of this legislative body. Thank you.
Thank you. At this time, we recognize Battalion Chief Colon for remarks.
We're going to do
Captain first?
Yes,
absolutely.
I'm sorry.
Go ahead. Please, sir.
I have the honor of not only calling Joaquin my friend, but my brother for the better part of 25 years. We started our friendship and brotherhood at Engine 2, which is at 2nd in York, and we have served the community since then. He not only broke the glass ceiling, but kicked it in for the rest of us. He made captain and opened the door for the rest of us, and we now have five Latino captains. So it is my great, great honor and privilege to say thank you, and we will miss you, I guess, to my brother, my friend, and the leader of our organization for many, many years. Battalion Chief, retired Battalion Chief Joaquin Colon Jr.
Thank you. Thanks, George, for those kind remarks. I want to say, standing up here, when you think about 34 years, it seems like a long time. But whatever we did, whether it was in the community, fighting fires, partnership with civic organizations and church groups, we did it with great pride and appreciation. So standing up here, you know, with great humbleness and pride. I'm proud to represent the Latino community, the citizens of Philadelphia, and the accomplishments that I've made. I accept this resolution, this award, with great humbleness and great pride. I also want to thank my wife, Elizabeth. Oh, I'm sorry. There you go. For being patient with me. And I also like to recognize my sister, Elena Colon, from New York. Elena, you want to stand up? Yeah, she fought a lot of traffic to get down here yesterday, so thank you. But again, I want to thank everyone here, all my friends and colleagues and so forth, for showing up today. I also want to thank Councilwoman María Quiñones, all the rest of the council members, and the mayor. I appreciate this. Thank you for the acknowledgement and the acclimates. Thank you.
Council, be at ease. Thank you so much, and again, congratulations, Chief. At this time, the chair recognizes Councilwoman Reynolds Brown, who will present a resolution honoring the African American Children's Book Project. With Vanessa Lloyd Scambati and those accompanying her, please join the Councilwoman at the podium. And joining the Councilwoman, we have Councilman Green. Councilwoman Blackwell, Councilwoman Parker, and Councilwoman Quiñones-Sánchez.
Thank you, Mr. President.
You're welcome.
Next to saluting women who are doing extraordinary things, and next to saluting anything arts and culture, for me, my next favorite experience here in City Council is saluting authors of children's books. I have enormous respect and admiration for those who have the ability to take their creative energy and then the discipline to reduce that creative energy to writing. Quite frankly, I'd have to admit that I envy authors of children's books. So with that confession, Edward Albee once remarked, "The act of writing is an act of optimism. You would not know the trouble to do it if you thought it did not matter." So if we accept that, and if we embrace the notion that nothing we do for children is ever wasted, then we know that the worth of a book is to be measured by what children can carry away from it. With that, it's always a wonderful pleasure for me to honor and recognize and lift up and celebrate the African Americans Children's Book Project on the occasion of the 25th Annual African American Children's Book Fair, and that February 4th is the kickoff of the National Literacy Initiative, Preserve a Legacy, Buy a Book. Whereas in 1926, noted historian Carter G. Woodson and the Association for the Study of Negro Life and History announced the second week of February to be Negro History Week. And
whereas the second week in February was chosen because of the birthdays of President Abraham Lincoln and Frederick Douglass. And whereas during early American history, African Americans were not allowed to learn to read and have books. In some states, the penalty for this infraction was death. And whereas the importance of book fairs cannot be understated, and for 24 years, the African American Children's Book Fair has enhanced multiculturalism in our city, utilizing the joy of reading as a tool. And whereas Vanessa Lloyd Scambati created the book fair because she believes books open up a world of opportunities for children, and after 24 years, the African American Children's Book Fair is the oldest and largest single day event for children's books in the country. And
whereas one of the most important reasons to encourage reading in our children is that studies show that the more our youth read, the more likely they are to make positive lifestyle decisions as they grow older. Literacy also makes our youth more productive global citizens. And whereas, strictly judging by attendance, the fair is a tremendous success. As well, over 3,500 people attended the fair in the past years from across the nation. And whereas, rich or poor, no one leaves empty-handed, as the books themselves are priced at a level where they are more affordable, and posters, bookmarkers, and raffle books are distributed free of charge to attendees. And whereas, the success of the event is reflected in four elements: the attendees, parents, children, caregivers, and educators, the authors and illustrators, the sponsors and the volunteers. Three of the esteemed participants will be Christine Kendall, Anzio Williams, and the volunteers. In October 2016, Scholastic Corp. published Kendall's debut novel, Riding Chance. The novel is nominated for a 2016 NAACP Image Literary Award. Riding Chance is a coming-of-age story about Troy's, an urban teen's, redemption through horses and the game of polo. The novel entails the story of Troy and his ability to summon the courage to determine his own identity. And
whereas Kendall's short fiction has also been published in Niche Literary Magazine and is forthcoming from the Quayle Journal. She also studied children's literature at the Southampton Writers Conference and was named a semifinalist in the 2014 River Styx Microfiction Contest. And whereas before becoming an author, Kendall held various recruitment and diversity positions at major law firms in Philadelphia and New York. In 2014, Kendall was honored to join the NAACP Legal Defense Fund to coordinate the 50th anniversary commemoration of the historic Brown versus Board of Education decision. She also served as executive assistant to LDF's director, council, and president.
And whereas in 2012, Anzio Williams joined the NBC 10 Philadelphia and Telemundo 62 family as the new director and vice president. Williams is an active member of the National Association for Black Journalists. He has served on many community boards and committees, such as the American Diabetes Association, Blood Source, and 100 Black Men of Sacramento. And
whereas as news director and vice president of NBC 10 Philadelphia and Telemundo 62, Williams has set an inclusive and diverse tone that serves the diverse needs of Philadelphia viewers. He has called diverse and inclusive news coverage as a, quote, necessary and serious news undertaking, end of quote, and
whereas in 2015, Williams was honored with the Philadelphia Association of Black Journalists Impact Award for his commitment to striving to build on the work of those who paved the way for him and acknowledging that race is still an issue to be tackled in the newsroom. He has led the charge to promote literacy in the region through the African American Children's Book Fair and serves as the steward and champion of the NBC 10 Telemundo 62 Reading Circle. And whereas volunteers are the glue that keeps everything together throughout our city and our nation. Since its inception, the African American Children's Book Project and its volunteers, Constance Ragsdale, Leslie Gaines, Beverly Gaines, Sheila Love, Barbara Tyree, Patricia Wellington, Deborah Turner, Deborah Johnson, Michelle Lloyd, and Jim Harris, that have so willingly given up their time to make sure that children in Philadelphia have access to books that empower, enrich, and enlighten their lives. These are the literacy ambassadors that promote our mantra, a book opens up a world of opportunities. And
whereas the 25th Annual African American Book Fair will be held free of charge, ink that on your schedules, this Saturday, February 4th, 2017, from 1 to 4 p.m. at the Community College of Philadelphia, who has been a steward and a sponsor and a help partner in this effort forever. Thank you, Lynette Brown So, located at 17th and Spring Garden Streets. Now, therefore, be it resolved by the Council of the City of Philadelphia that we hereby honor, recognize, salute, and congratulate the African American Children's Book Project on the occasion of the 25th Annual African American Children's Book Fair, and that February 4th is the kickoff of the National Literacy Initiative. Preserve a legacy, buy a book. Let's salute Vanessa Lloyd Scambati, Anzia Williams, and all the others.
Thank you, Blondell. I call her the literary politician. And of course, President Del Clark, he has been an inspiration to many of us here in the city. We knew when he was just sitting on the sidelines, and he's gone on to lead the city in a very effective way. And also many of you council people who have not supported it by coming out to the event, I encourage you to show your face. You will meet the next generation of Philadelphians who are going to be productive and make this city thrive. I want to acknowledge a couple of things before I pass the mic. I'm not going to take too much time here because y'all know I love to talk about myself. You know, when I started this journey, I was told that you needed a couple of elements to make it a success. Quarter of a century ago. You need a location, you need talent, you need sponsors, and media. Thanks to Lynette Brown So, I found a location so that every year, that's not one of the things I have to worry about. Talent. We have the best and the brightest. And when people hear me say that, they're like, yeah. These are all the people who win the American Library Association Awards, all the mega awards in the industry. In fact, the person who won the best children's illustrated book out of 10,000 books is going to be here in Philadelphia, and we'll be giving away that person's book also at the event. Sponsors. Anzio Williams has been NBC 10, Telemundo 62. They came in. They said, what can we do to help? They used to give a Black History Party, so now they give books to children. They will give away 500 brand new books. Each child that attends this event is going to have a book that's appropriate to their interests. And I can't forget Melanie Lassiter, Sharon Powell. They work for companies that have supported this effort. And the media. Anzio wears two hats here. He's a part of the media who makes sure we get accurate coverage. And I believe Cherry Gregg and WRD is broadcasting, and WDS and WUSL. These are all people who've gotten the message out to the community about this wonderful event. And if you want to do an event and you want to do it with class and style, you got to have great volunteers. And the people standing in back of me are people who come and selfishly give up their time. They don't get paid, and I am a diva. Well, I like to say I'm a princess in exile, okay? I don't have a court, so I work what I could work with. But before I pass on the mic, the people who are standing here, I've known them, I won't say since I'm a child, because then somebody's gonna pull me aside and say, we're the same age. But Janie Blackwell, who's been a friend and also a champion of literacy, María Quiñones, who's also another champion. Sherelle, I really have known her since she was a kid. And Blondell Reynolds Brown, who has always made sure that we kick off Black History Month here in City Council in the appropriate way. No singing, no dancing. It is all about the books. So I encourage everyone to come out. People like Wells Fargo, PICO, Comcast, Health Partners Plan will be giving books to teachers to use in their classrooms, books of guest award-winning authors and illustrators, as well as there's lots of books and things to purchase. So I'm going to pass the mic over to Christine. Christine came to my book fair for 3 years in a row, and she stood in line, because there is a line to get in, and 3 years later, she has a book published by one of the top publishers, Scholastic Books, as well as she got nominated for an NAACP Image Award. Then Anzio will step to the mic. He's like a homeboy now. We love him. He's always doing something to help the community. And Patrika Wellington will speak on behalf of the volunteers, and we'll let you get back to the business of running Philadelphia.
Thank you. It's truly an honor to be here. On Saturday, thousands of kids and families will once again stand in long lines on Spring Garden Street in the winter's cold, waiting for the doors to the African American Children's Book Fair to open. The doors to the world of books. If you stand in that line with your fellow Philadelphians, you too will feel the energy of young readers hungry for more good books. It's an unforgettable experience. I've attended the book fair in the past as a consumer, and this year I'm honored to be a participating author with my debut novel, Riding Chance. But more importantly, I'm so very happy that this book fair is alive and well and celebrating its 25th year. I salute Vanessa Lloyd-Scambati for her hard work and dedication, and I look forward to there being a book fair for many years to come. Thank you.
I just wanted to quickly acknowledge Kenyatta Johnson. He has been supporting the book fair also.
Mr. President, and the council, thank you. Thank you to Vanessa for having the vision to put together a book fair like this and continue to work. And if anybody knows Vanessa, when she calls, and then the second time she calls, and the third time she calls, she's not going to give up. But I thank her for allowing NBC10 and Telemundo 62 to be a part of this. As the Vice President of News, I have a front row seat to what happens when kids go the wrong way. You know, most of the time, if you watch the news, you know, we are showing the bad side of things. And so this is an opportunity for us to get out in front of things. This is an opportunity for us to have an impact on kids' lives in a positive way. I always say, if you can read and you can write, you'll have a job forever. If you can read and you can write, you'll have a job forever. So again, I thank the council, and I thank Vanessa for the vision and this project. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Patrika Wellington, and I'm a volunteer for the Children's Project, African American Children's Project. It's been a pleasure. For over 20 plus years, I've been coming from
actually Wilmington, Delaware, to come and volunteer at this fabulous affair that she gives in every year. I do look forward to it. I work with the volunteers. We come in early to get it prepared for 1 o'clock to see everybody come through those doors, and we work diligently. Thanks to Vanessa, who is something, somebody remarkable, I give all kudos to her for putting this together. I have not seen anything like this. I'm from Brooklyn, New York. I have not seen it. I live in Wilmington. I brought a bus up from Wilmington of students as a retired teacher. I went to Brooklyn, brought my niece's nephew to this. It's a wonderful, wonderful. Keep reading. That's all I can tell you. Thank you very much, Vanessa.
Thank you. Council will be at ease.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. And our next order of business is communications, and the chair requests that the Sergeant of Arms delivers the messages from the mayor to the chief clerk. Thank you. Mr. Decker, would you please read those messages?
To the President and members of the Council of the City of Philadelphia, I am transmitting herewith for the consideration of your honorable body an ordinance authorizing the Commissioner of Public Property to convey to the Philadelphia Authority for Industrial Development all or part of a parcel of land located in the area bounded by J Street, East Tioga Street, and Kensington Avenue for further conveyance. And an ordinance authorizing the Commissioner of Public Property on behalf of the City of Philadelphia to convey to the Philadelphia Authority for Industrial Development all or part of a parcel of land located in the area bounded by Ridge Avenue, Leverington Avenue, Mitchell Street, and Crams Avenue for further conveyance. And an ordinance authorizing the Commissioner of Public Property and the Director of Commerce on behalf of the city to acquire an approximately 136-acre property known as the Airport Business Center, located in Tinicum Township, Delaware County, together with all improvements thereon, all under certain terms and conditions.
You have any additional communication, Mr. Decker?
I have none, Mr. President.
Thank you very much. All right, next order of business will be the introduction of bills and resolutions, and the chair recognizes Councilwoman Reynolds Brown.
Good morning, Mr. President.
Good morning.
I offer one resolution co-sponsored by members Green, Gim, and Taltenberger.
Thank you, Councilwoman.
A privileged resolution authorizing City Council's Committee on the Environment to hold public hearings to investigate the current and future state of Philadelphia's environment.
This week's calendar. And the chair recognizes Councilwoman Blackwell.
Thank you, Mr. President. Today I introduce two bills.
Thank you, Councilwoman.
An ordinance authorizing the revision of lines and grades in a portion of City Plan Number 269 by relocating portions of the house lines and curb lines of Convention Avenue from 34th Street to Health Sciences Drive.
Referred to committee.
And an ordinance amending Chapter 10611 of the Philadelphia Code entitled Sidewalk Behavior by providing certain requirements for obtaining a permit to place street furniture, planters, benches, and other fixtures in the public sidewalk.
Referred to committee. Chair recognizes Councilman Greenlee.
Thank you, Mr. President. On your behalf, I offer one bill and one resolution.
Thank you, Councilman.
An ordinance amending Chapter 2200 entitled Recording of Deeds to prohibit the recording of any deed or instrument transferring title to real estate if delinquent payments are owed to the city.
Referred to committee.
And a non-privileged resolution authorizing the Commissioner of Public Property to execute and deliver to the Philadelphia Redevelopment Authority without consideration deeds conveying conditional fees, simple title to certain city-owned lots or pieces of ground with the buildings and improvements thereon, situated in the 43rd Ward of the City of Philadelphia.
Next week's final passes calendar. The chair recognizes Councilman Heenan.
Thank you, Council President. Today I offer one bill.
Thank you, Councilman.
An ordinance authorizing the Commissioner of Public Property on behalf of the city to acquire fee, simple title, or a lesser interest in real estate in parcels of land along the Delaware River and the Kensington and Taconi Trail.
And that will be referred to committee. Chair recognizes Councilwoman Quiñones-Sánchez.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Good morning. I have one bill on your behalf, one bill for me, and two non-privileged resolutions.
Thank you, Councilwoman.
An ordinance authorizing the Commissioner of Public Property on behalf of the City of Philadelphia to convey to the Philadelphia Authority for Industrial Development all or part of a parcel of land located in the area bounded by J Street, East Tioga Street, and Kensington Avenue for further conveyance.
Referred to committee.
And an ordinance amending Title 4 of the Philadelphia Code entitled the Philadelphia Building Construction and Occupancy Code by amending Subcode A, the Philadelphia Administrative Code, and Subcode B, the Philadelphia Building Code, to add and revise certain provisions relating to the demolition of buildings and structures.
Referred to committee.
And a non-privileged resolution authorizing the Commissioner of Public Property to execute and deliver to the Philadelphia Redevelopment Authority without consideration deeds conveying conditional fees, simple title to certain city on lots of pieces of ground with the buildings and improvements thereon situated in the 7th Ward of the City of Philadelphia.
And that will be on next week's final passes calendar.
And a non-privileged resolution recognizing the life and legacy of Luisa Chariez de Morales for her dedication to the Latino community and renaming the 3700 block of North 7th Street between West Erie Avenue and West Butler Street, Luisa Chariez de Morales Paseo.
And that will be on next week's final passes calendar. The chair recognizes Councilman Green.
Good morning, Council President.
Good morning.
I have one privileged resolution.
Thank you, Councilman.
A privileged resolution recognizing Philadelphia's ceasefire for their ongoing violence reduction efforts in the City of Philadelphia.
This week's final passes calendar. The chair recognizes Councilwoman Parker.
Thank you, Mr. President. I have no bills or resolutions today.
Thank you, Councilwoman. Chair recognizes Councilman Don.
Thank you, Council President. I have no bills or resolutions today.
Thank you, Councilman. Chair recognizes Councilwoman Gim.
Thank you, Council President. I have no bills or resolutions.
Thank you, Councilwoman. Chair recognizes Councilman Taubenberger.
Good morning, Council President and colleagues. I have no bills or resolutions today.
Thank you, Councilman. Chair recognizes Councilman O'Neill.
Thank you, Mr. President. I have no bills or resolutions.
Thank you, Councilman. Chair recognizes Councilman Squilla.
Thank you, Mr. President. I have one bill.
Thank you, Councilman.
An ordinance authorizing High Goldberg to construct, own, and maintain a bench encroachment at 701 Sansom Street.
And that bill will be referred to the appropriate committee. Chair recognizes Councilwoman Bass.
Thank you, Mr. President. I offer two resolutions.
Thank you, Councilwoman.
A non-privileged resolution condemning President Trump's executive order banning people from Muslim-majority nations from entering the United States, an unconstitutional, unlawful, and un-American.
And I'll be on next week's final passes calendar.
And a non-privileged resolution recognizing the victims of the mass shooting at the Quebec Islamic Center, condemning religious intolerance and Islamophobia, and affirming support for Philadelphia's Muslim community.
And that will also be next week's final passes calendar. Chair recognizes Councilman O.
Thank you very much. I offer two bills and one privilege resolutions collectively co-sponsored by Councilman Mark Squilla, Councilman Green, Domb, Reynolds Brown, and Bass. Thank you.
Thank you, Councilman.
An ordinance amending Section 12-1131 of the Philadelphia Code entitled Electric Vehicle Parking to impose a moratorium on new electric vehicle parking spaces.
Referred to a committee.
And an ordinance amending Title 17 of the Philadelphia Code entitled Contracts and Procurement by adding measures to bring greater transparency, equitability, and accessibility to the process of procurement of disadvantaged business enterprises while encouraging disadvantaged business enterprises to grow in size and capability.
Also referred to committee.
And a privileged resolution recognizing and honoring the 2016 winners of PHL Live Center Stage.
And this was that now. And that will be on this week's final passage calendar. That concludes our introduction of bills and resolutions. We will now have our reports from committee. And the chair recognizes Councilman Squilla for a report from the Committee on Transportation and Public Utilities.
Thank you, Mr. President. The Committee on Transportation and Public Utilities reports one bill with a favorable recommendation.
Thank you, Councilman. Mr. Decker, please read your report.
To the President and members of the Council of the City of Philadelphia, the Committee on Transportation and Public Utilities, which is referred Bill Number 161058, entitled An Ordinance Adopting an Amendment to the Articles of Incorporation of the Philadelphia Energy Authority, increasing the number of members on the Authority's board from 5 to 7, as proposed by the board in a resolution adopted November 30, 2016. Respectful reports, it is considered the same and returns the attached bill to council with a favorable recommendation.
Thank you. The chair again recognizes Councilman Squilla.
Thank you, Mr. President. I move that the rules of council be suspended so to permit the first reading this day of Bill Number 161058.
Thank you. It has been moved and properly seconded that the rules of council be suspended so as to permit first reading this day of Bills Number 161058. All those in favor say aye. Those opposed, the ayes have it. And that bill will be on our first reading calendar today. That concludes our committee report. And the next order of business is the consideration of calendar. I note that the bill just reported from committee with the suspension of the rules has been deemed to have had a first reading. This bill will be placed on our second reading and final passage calendar for the next session of council. As there are no additional bills on the first reading calendar, the chair recognizes Councilman Heenan for the purpose of calling on bills and resolutions on the final passage calendar today.
Thank you, Mr. President. The following resolutions and bills are being called up for the second reading and final passage calendars today. Bill numbers 1611, 1470028, 1700029, 1700032, 1700033, 1700034, 1700035, 1700036, 1700037, 1700041, 1700044, 1700545, 1700049, 1700050, 1700051, 1700055, 1700058, 1700063, 1600007, 1600248, 1600808, 1600999, 1600720. All other bills and resolutions are being held.
Those last ones are all held. I think they're all held. Because
one of them
is yours.
Didn't he want to help us? What do we got? correction on the bills on final passage today. My mistake. 160248 is being held, and it is not on today's final passage.
I think all of them, Bob. You read all of them.
Well, you know what?
Chair again recognizes Councilman Heenan.
Council President and colleagues, I apologize for the corrections that I will now read off for the following resolutions and bills that are being held in today's final reading. So the corrections are 161114, 170041, 170044, 170051, 160007, 160248, 160808, 160999, and 160720 are not on today's final passage in today's calendar. They are all being held.
Thank you, Councilman. Before considering these bills and resolutions on a final passage calendar, we will have our public comment session. If you had an interest in testifying on a bill or resolution that is on the final passage calendar today, if you have not already done so, you may sign up at the table to my left. When your name is called, you will go to the podium in the middle of the council chambers. There is a device on that podium. When the light turns green, it will be your time to speak. When the light turns yellow, you will have 30 seconds to conclude your remarks. When the light turns red, we would ask that you please adhere to the guidelines and conclude your remarks. You will be given three minutes to testify. Mr. Decker, please call the name of the first witness.
Joe Danahel, commenting on 170028, 170029, 170045, 170044, 170037, 170032, 170036, 170035, and 170034.
Thank you, sir. Good morning.
Good morning. This is yet another decree from the people, and as such, must be acted upon immediately. 14th Amendment of the U.S. Constitution. No state shall make or enforce any law which shall abridge the privileges or immunities of citizens of the United States, nor shall any state deprive any people of life, liberty, or property. Property ownership is hard. You have to struggle to save money to purchase. Property ownership by sovereign people is a goal of a just government. John Adams is quoted, "The moment the idea is admitted into society that property is not as sacred as the laws of God, and that there is no force of law and public justice to protect it, anarchy and tyranny commence. If thou shalt not covet, if thou shalt not steal, were not commandments of heaven, they must be made inviolable precepts in every society before it can be civilized or made free." Founding fathers wrote extensively about the absolute sovereignty of people's property rights, laws with strict and absolute penalties for government officials who violate the rights were passed. Is this elected monarchy above the law? I call again for federal and Commonwealth governments to perform their constitutional obligations to investigate, prosecute all involved in the theft, illegal deed transfer, and deprivation of property rights for 23 years of my home, 1038 West Wyoming. Immediate remedy is required by the Constitution. A just government must comply with the rule of law. This color of law government must have its charter revoked and made constitutionally compliant. The rule of law demands it. It takes a lot of cooperation to create and allow monumental corruption. Civil servants cannot refuse their sworn duty any more than a fireman can refuse to fight a fire.
Thank you for your testimony.
There are no other speakers in the public comment list, Mr. President.
Thank you very much, Mr. Decker. That concludes our public comment. We will now move to our calendar. Mr. Decker, please read the title 170028.
A resolution authorizing the Commissioner of Public Property to execute and deliver to the Philadelphia Redevelopment Authority without consideration deeds conveying conditional fee simple title to certain city on lots of pieces of ground with the buildings and improvements thereon situated in the 6th Ward of the City of Philadelphia.
Chair recognizes Councilwoman Blackwell.
Thank you, Mr. President. I move for the adoption of the resolution.
Second.
It's been moved and properly second. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, the ayes have it. Resolution 170028 is adopted. Mr. Decker, 170029.
A resolution authorizing the Commissioner of Public Property to execute and deliver to the Philadelphia Redevelopment Authority without consideration deeds conveying conditional fees, simple title to certain city-owned lots or pieces of ground with the buildings and improvements thereon situated in the 24th Ward of the City of Philadelphia.
Chair again recognizes Councilwoman Blackwell.
Thank you, Mr. President. I move for the adoption of the resolution.
Second.
It's been moved and properly second. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, ayes have it. And Resolution 170029 is adopted. Mr. Decker, 170032.
A resolution authorizing the Philadelphia Land Bank to dispose of certain properties located in the 5th Councilmanic District.
Chair recognizes Councilman Greenlee.
Thank you, Mr. President. I move the adoption of the resolution.
Second.
It's been moved and properly second. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, ayes have it. And Resolution 170032 is adopted. Mr. Decker, 170033.
A resolution authorizing the Philadelphia Land Bank to dispose of certain properties located in the 5th Councilmanic District.
Chair again recognizes Councilman Greenlee.
Thank you, Mr. President. Move the adoption of the resolution.
Second.
It's been moved and properly second. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, ayes have it. 170033 is adopted. Mr. Decker, 170034.
A resolution authorizing the Philadelphia Land Bank to dispose of certain properties located in the 5th Councilmanic District.
Chair recognizes Councilman Greenlee.
Thank you, Mr. President. Move the adoption of the resolution.
Been moved and properly second. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, ayes have it. 170034 is adopted. Mr. Decker, 170035.
A resolution authorizing the Philadelphia Land Bank to dispose of certain properties located in the 5th Councilmanic District.
Chair, one more time, recognizes Councilman Greenlee.
Actually, it'll be a few more times. Thank you, Mr. President. I move the adoption of the resolution.
It's been moved and properly second. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, ayes have it. 170035 is adopted. 170036.
A resolution authorizing the Philadelphia Land Bank to dispose of certain properties located in the 5th Councilmanic District.
Might as well call Councilman Greenlee again.
Yeah. Right. Thank you, Mr. President. I move the adoption of the resolution.
Second.
All right. It's been moved and properly second. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, ayes have it. 170036. Is adopted. Mr. Decker, 170037.
A resolution authorizing the Philadelphia Redevelopment Authority to execute and deliver to the Philadelphia Land Bank deeds conveying title to certain properties located in the 5th Councilmanic District.
And the chair recognizes Councilman Greenlee.
Thank you, Mr. President. I move the adoption of the resolution.
Second.
It's been moved and properly second. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, ayes have it. 170037 is adopted. Mr. Decker, 170045.
A resolution calling on the United States Senate to reject U.S. Senator Jeff Sessions' nomination for the office of U.S. Attorney General.
And the chair recognizes Councilwoman Quiñones-Sánchez. No? Who's on that? Chair recognizes Councilwoman Parker.
Thank you, Mr. President. On behalf of Councilman Johnson, I move for the adoption of the resolution.
Thank you. Before we call, Chair, want to recognize, before we call for the vote, Chair recognizes Councilman O'Neill.
Yes, Mr. President, I just want to be recorded as voting no on this resolution.
Yes, sir. And the Chair also recognizes Councilman Taubenberger.
Council President, I respect that I have a recorded as no on this resolution. Thank you.
Thank you, Councilman. And the Chair recognizes Councilman O.
Thank you, Council President. I'll be voting no as well. Thank you.
Thank you. It's been moved and properly seconded on 170-045. All those in favor say aye. Those opposed? The ayes have it. Let the record reflect that Councilman O'Neill, Taubenberger, and O voted nay. Majority of members voted aye. 170-045 is adopted. Mr. Decker, 170-049.
A resolution authorizing the Commissioner of Public Property to execute and deliver to the Philadelphia Redevelopment Authority without consideration deeds conveying conditional fee simple title to certain city-owned lots or pieces of ground with the buildings and improvements thereon situated in the 31st Ward of the City of Philadelphia.
Chair recognizes Councilwoman Quiñones-Sánchez.
Thank you. I move for its adoption.
It's been moved and properly seconded. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, ayes have it. And resolution 170-049 is adopted. Mr. Decker, 170-050.
A resolution authorizing the Philadelphia Land Bank to dispose of certain properties located in the 7th Councilman District.
Chair, again, recognizes Councilwoman Quiñones-Sánchez.
I move for its adoption.
Can I get a second? Second. It's been moved and properly seconded. All those in favor?
Aye.
Those opposed? Ayes have it. 170-050 has been adopted. Mr. Decker, 170-055.
A resolution calling for the adoption and implementation of the 2016 Assessment of Fair Housing Report, recently submitted to the U.S. Department of Housing and Urban Development to meet the goals of the Affirmatively Furthering Fair Housing Rule.
Chair recognizes Councilman Don. It's been moved and properly seconded. All those in favor say aye. Those opposed, ayes have it. 170-055 is adopted. Mr. Decker, 170-058.
A resolution approving the redevelopment contract of the Philadelphia Redevelopment Authority for the redevelopment and urban renewal of a portion of the new Kensington Fishtown urban renewal area identified by house number and street address as 2323 East York Street.
Chair recognizes Councilman Squilla.
Thank you, Mr. President. I move for the adoption.
It's been moved and properly seconded. All those in favor say aye. Those opposed, ayes have it. 170-058 is adopted. Mr. Decker, 170-063.
A resolution appointing. A resolution appointing 15 individuals to the task force on the Philadelphia music industry.
And the chair recognizes Councilman O.
Thank you very much. I move for the adoption of the resolution.
It's been moved and properly seconded. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, ayes have it. 170-063 is adopted. Is that it? That's it. No bills. All right. Mr. Decker, you have any additional resolutions?
A resolution authorizing City Council's Committee on the Environment to hold public hearings to investigate the current and future state of Philadelphia's environment, introduced by Councilwoman Reynolds Brown.
Chair recognizes Councilwoman Reynolds Brown.
Thank you, Mr. President. I move for the adoption.
Second. It's been moved and properly seconded. All those in favor say aye. Those opposed, ayes have it. And that resolution is adopted.
And a resolution recognizing Philadelphia's ceasefire for their ongoing violence reduction efforts in the City of Philadelphia, introduced by Councilman Green.
Chair recognizes Councilman Green.
Thank you, Council President. I move for the adoption of the resolution.
It's been moved and properly seconded. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, ayes have it. And that resolution is adopted.
And a resolution recognizing and honoring the 2016 winners of PHL Live Center Stage, introduced by Councilman O.
Chair recognizes Councilman O.
Thank you very much. I move for the adoption of the resolution.
It's been moved and properly seconded. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, ayes have it. And that resolution is adopted.
There are no other resolutions on the final passage calendar, Mr. President.
Thank you very much, Mr. Decker. Are there any speeches on the part of the minority? Chair recognizes Councilman O.
Thank you very much. I just wanted to alert my colleagues that I did introduce a bill regarding minority-owned, women-owned, and persons with disability-owned businesses for Section 17500. It's lengthy and complicated. I do understand that. So I did summarize what the ordinance would do, the changes it would make, and I've placed that on the desk of every councilperson. I'd invite anyone who would like to have this discussion. I think we've discussed this, quite frankly, over the many months. I have distributed a draft previously. I've spoken to some people in the administration, and I know it's been a constant source of discussion among our body over at least the 5 years that I've been here. To date, my understanding is that the executive order that was last put in place expired. And though I've heard various things, most recently an articulation of what would be done by Rebecca Reinhart, who is no longer holding that position, I've not seen anything in writing. I was delighted to hear when she testified statements made that were very consistent with our discussions and what was put in the draft and in this ordinance. And therefore, I have introduced this bill, and I think if it's not in writing, it's just vague. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Councilman. Are there any speeches on behalf of the majority? They're seeing none. Chair recognizes Councilwoman Reynolds Brown for a motion to adjourn.
Thank you, Mr. President. I move that council stand adjourned until Thursday, February 9th at 10 a.m.
Second. It's been moved and properly second. The council stand adjourned until Thursday, February 9th, 2017. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, the ayes have it. Thank you all very much.
Is Kurt okay?
Thank you.